Thank you for joining us today on this very special Christmas program. We have with us today Pastor Dan Scott, Senior Pastor of Christ Church in Nashville, and we are so glad you're here with us today.
I'm delighted to
Thank
be here,
you.
Diana. Thanks.
Thank you.
As a kid in West Virginia, of course, we loved Christmas, and we were poor, didn't know it, but usually there would be snow and just looked like postcards everywhere, but we just thought that's the way life was. There were lights, and we had all kinds of songs. There's always a song in West Virginia. No matter how poor people are, they have these tremendous repertoire of music. And this was a song I remember loving as a kid. Sweet little Jesus boy, they made you be born in a manger. Sweet little holy child, we didn't know who you were. We didn't know you come to save us, Lord, to take our sins away. Our eyes were blind and we could not see, 'cause we just didn't know who you were. They treat you mean, Lord. Sometimes they treat me mean too. That's the way things are done around here, 'cause we just don't know who you are. Sweet little Jesus boy, they made you be born in a manger. Dear sweet little Jesus child, we didn't know who you were. We just didn't know you came to save us, Lord, to take our sins away. Our eyes were blind and we could not see. We didn't know who you were. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hill and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. It was in the tiny manger that the humble child was born. And God sent down salvation that early Christmas morn. Hallelujah, go tell it on the mountain, over the hill and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. He made me a watchman upon the city wall and said, if I be a Christian, I am the least of all. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hill and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Pastor Dan, you have just recently become senior pastor of Christ Church. Tell us how this has impacted your life.
Well, this church impacted my life. I was 31 years old when I first came to this church in 1984. I'd been serving a church in Montreal, Canada, for a number of years. And when we left Canada, we really didn't know where we were going. I had two little children. And this church opened up to us to help serve Pastor Hardwick, who was a senior pastor at the time. And worked here for 10 years, and the church impacted me greatly. We had huge growth during that time. There was just a real move of the Spirit. And the church grew. But after 10 years, we went to Phoenix, Arizona. We're there for 10 years at the Valley Cathedral.
in Phoenix. And five years ago, the Lord in His providence brought us back to Christ Church, became the senior pastor a year ago. And I love this church, and it's meant so much to me and has had such an impact in my life. Now it's my desire to see the church continue to have this tremendous impact that it's had, particularly in the creative community, on artists, singers, writers. This church has had that kind of creative edge through the years, and that's my desire to see that continue. My books are available on Amazon as well, if you're out of the city. Okay. But Faith to Faith, I wrote it because, you know, my grandparents' generation in the U.S., they may have known that Buddhists existed. I'm sure they did. But, you know, they had no reason to ever talk about Buddhism. They knew that somebody named Muhammad had lived, but they didn't know anything about him. Nowadays, a Buddhist or a Islamic person lives, a Muslim lives across the street. So people are afraid. I think a lot of Christians are afraid, and they think, well, what do I say to someone that's a Buddhist, a Muslim, a Hindu, a Sikh, all these different religions, and we become frightened of them. And they're not to be frightened. We don't need to be frightened of them. The fact is there's a uniqueness in Christ that differs from Muhammad or Buddha or any of the other religious leaders of the world. They said many wonderful things, things that a Christian can affirm. But, of course, Christ died for us, gave His life for us, and He is God in flesh in ways that none of these other spiritual leaders ever even claimed to be. So I wrote the book. It's an easy-to-read book. A lot of books on religion are difficult to read, and you know, you lose interest third page. But these are stories of people who are Hindus or Buddhists or whatever, and why that Christianity differs from the path that they've chosen to take in life or were born into.
Well, it's a very, very good book, and I encourage you to read it to open up your understanding as far as the other religions and everything. But also, just let everyone know, if you want to watch Christ Church, it's live streaming on Sunday mornings, 11 o'clock. It's just a wonderful service. And also, Sunday p.m. is another service that's live streaming on Sunday nights at 6:30. But just go to ChristChurchNashville.org and click on the sermons and watch now, and it's just great. I know that you'll be blessed by it and by the ministry of Pastor Dan and the Christ Church Choir and everything that it has. But we just appreciate you being here today.
Oh,
thank you.
I loved it.